Stellantis has just shattered expectations with a bombshell announcement. The end of Ram trucks, one of America's most iconic vehicles, a name synonymous with power and reliability, is being phased out. Imagine walking into a dealership expecting to see the truck that's been a staple of American roads, only to find it's gone. But why would Stellantis make such a drastic move? Can the fiercely competitive truck market withstand such a disruption? And most importantly, what does this mean for loyal Ram owners, hardworking employees, and the future of American trucks? The end of an era. The Ram 1500 Classic is being phased out, and Stellantis isn't exactly trying to downplay the drama. Earlier this year, whispers about the model's discontinuation were dismissed as rumors, but by mid-July, Stellantis confirmed it was scaling back production at the Warren Truck Assembly Plant in Michigan. The announcement wasn't just a quiet restructuring, it came with devastating consequences. Nearly 2,500 workers at the plant lost their jobs. Fast forward a few months, and Stellantis delivered another blow. Over 4,000 additional workers faced temporary layoffs. For the Ram 1500 Classic, it wasn't just the end of a production line, it marked the unraveling of an era. These layoffs were accompanied by cuts at the Toledo Assembly Complex, where workers producing Jeep Gladiators faced two-week production halts. Nearly half of the facility's 5,000 employees found themselves in limbo, uncertain about their future. But why is this happening to such a beloved model? To answer that, we need to talk about the numbers driving Stellantis' decisions. Stellantis struggles. The decision to phase out the Ram 1500 Classic is rooted in cold, hard numbers. The first half of 2024 revealed a 19.5% drop in sales compared to the previous year. That's over 45,000 fewer trucks sold, a staggering decline for a model that once dominated its segment. The problem isn't just about the Ram 1500 Classic. Stellantis' entire portfolio is struggling. Jeep, another pillar of the company, saw sales drop 19% year over year, with iconic models like the Wrangler and Grand Cherokee posting double-digit declines. Dodge is faring no better, with the Challenger and Charger facing significant sales hits as their current generations near the end of production. At the heart of the issue is Stellantis' struggle to balance tradition with innovation. Competitors like Ford and Chevy are excelling with models that blend modern tech and affordability. Meanwhile, Stellantis is betting heavily on electrification, a pivot that's consuming resources while leaving some of its most loyal customers behind. The industry-wide ripples. The fallout from Stellantis' decision to phase out the Ram 1500 Classic isn't confined to its factories. When a truck that defined reliability and power disappears, it sends ripples through the entire automotive industry. Dealerships are already grappling with surplus inventory and declining foot traffic as consumers shy away from higher-priced models. But the effects go even deeper. Local economies that rely on Stellantis' factories are taking a hit. Small businesses near the Warren Truck Assembly Plant report fewer customers as laid-off workers tighten their budgets. Community resources like food banks and social services are under increasing strain, trying to support families caught in the fallout. Union leaders, led by the outspoken Sean Fain, are calling this a disgrace. They argue that Stellantis is prioritizing cost-cutting over worker welfare, even as executives enjoy hefty bonuses. The United Auto Workers Union has ramped up its rhetoric, describing these layoffs as an attack on American industry itself. Stellantis at a crossroads. According to Stellantis CEO Carlos Tavares, these drastic measures are part of a broader strategy to cut costs by 30% while transitioning to electric vehicles. In his view, the automotive industry is at a crossroads, with every brand facing unprecedented challenges. Yet Tavares claims Stellantis is positioned for success, touting the company's pivot to luxury, electrification, and limited edition models as the way forward. Not everyone is buying it. Critics point out that while Stellantis sings the praises of its strategy, it's failing to support the workers and communities that made its success possible. Meanwhile, the decision to introduce high-priced models like the Ram TRX Final Edition has raised eyebrows. Is Stellantis innovating, or is it simply out of touch with the average consumer? The narrative Stellantis is pushing is clear. This is a necessary transformation for survival in a changing industry. But for workers and loyal Ram customers, it feels more like a betrayal. A dying icon. The Ram 1500 Classic, long considered a workhorse and symbol of resilience on American roads, isn't just a truck, it's a cultural icon. For decades, it has served everyone from construction workers to road trip adventurers, earning a loyal following along the way. Yet in 2024, the numbers paint a grim picture. Sales of the Ram 1500 have dropped by a staggering 19.5% in the first half of the year. That's approximately 45,000 fewer trucks rolling off dealership lots compared to the same period in 2023. This steep decline is more than a statistical anomaly. It's a reflection of a changing market. Trucks that were once staples of functionality and reliability are struggling to keep up with shifting consumer demands. Stellantis' competitors, such as Ford with its F-Series and Chevy with its Silverado, are surging ahead, offering innovations that blend tradition with cutting-edge technology. Meanwhile, Stellantis seems caught in a web of outdated strategies and an inability to adapt quickly enough. The loss of sales isn't limited to Ram. Other Stellantis brands, including Jeep, Dodge, and Chrysler, are experiencing similar declines. Jeep has seen a 19% drop in sales, with models like the Wrangler and Grand Cherokee suffering from a 17 and 26% decline, respectively. Dodge isn't immune either, as the Challenger and Charger face double-digit losses. These numbers aren't just about trucks and cars. They signal a deeper issue within Stellantis' approach to staying competitive in a rapidly evolving automotive landscape. The price dilemma. For decades, Ram trucks have been synonymous with rugged reliability and value for money. But as prices climb, this image is starting to crack. The starting price for the 2025 Ram 1500 has soared to nearly $70,000, with high-end trims pushing well beyond $80,000. These price points are not just steep, they're exclusionary. For many in the working class, who have historically been Ram's core customers, these figures are simply out of reach. When financial experts suggest that car payments should not exceed 10 to 15% of one's monthly income, it becomes clear why so many consumers are balking. To comfortably afford an $80,000 truck, an individual would need to earn upwards of $150,000 a year, a far cry from what most buyers in Ram's target market take home. Combined with rising living costs, from groceries to housing and increasing interest rates, these prices make owning a new Ram truck an almost unattainable dream for the average consumer. The pricing dilemma isn't just about the sticker price. Depreciation has also become a significant concern for potential buyers. A brand new truck that loses 15 to 20% of its value as soon as it leaves the dealership is a tough sell, especially when paired with high monthly payments. For many, the financial math simply doesn't add up, pushing them to either delay their purchase or look to competitors offering better value. Reliability concerns. While Ram trucks have earned praise for their power and features, reliability issues have become an Achilles heel for the brand. One persistent issue is the infamous Hemi lifter tick, a problem that has plagued many Ram 1500 owners. The ticking noise caused by faulty lifters often appears around the 70,000 mile mark. Left unchecked, it can lead to more serious problems like worn camshafts, ultimately resulting in costly engine repairs. For some, the solution lies in using higher quality oil, but this is at best a temporary fix, not a permanent solution. Other recurring problems include broken or warped manifold bolts, which can lead to exhaust leaks and reduced fuel efficiency. Addressing these issues often involves intensive labor, as removing and replacing the bolts can be a time-consuming and expensive process. Additionally, Stellantis has faced a series of recalls, further denting consumer confidence. One significant recall in 2024 involved poor welding in the transmission control unit of certain Ram trucks, leading to potential leaks and even a loss of driving power. These reliability concerns aren't just inconvenient, they're costly. For buyers who are already stretching their budgets to afford a new truck, the prospect of expensive repairs down the line is enough to make them hesitate. Competitors like Ford and Toyota, which consistently rank higher in reliability studies, are becoming increasingly attractive alternatives. Union battles and worker demands. As Stellantis grapples with declining sales and rising costs, another battle is raging within its workforce. Union leaders, particularly those from the United Auto Workers, are intensifying their efforts to secure better conditions for employees. At the heart of their demands is job security. Layoffs across Stellantis plants have left thousands of workers in limbo, and union leaders argue that the company's priorities are skewed. Why, they ask, are executives receiving massive pay increases while workers are left to fend for themselves? The UAW's demands extend beyond job retention. They are pushing for a revival of essential benefits, such as improved healthcare and retirement plans, which have been eroded over the years. Another critical issue is fair compensation for new hires, who often start at significantly lower wages than their more experienced counterparts. The union argues that this pay disparity not only affects morale, but also makes it harder to attract and retain talent in a competitive labor market. One of the most contentious issues is executive compensation. Stellantis executives have enjoyed pay raises of up to 56%, even as the company cuts costs through layoffs and reduced operations. For workers and union leaders, this is a bitter pill to swallow. The contrast between the struggles of everyday employees and the financial rewards at the top has fueled anger and calls for accountability. Sean Fain, the president of the UAW, has emerged as a vocal critic of Stellantis' leadership. He has rallied workers with fiery speeches, emphasizing the need for solidarity and collective action. Under his leadership, the union has threatened large-scale strikes if Stellantis fails to address their demands. These strikes aren't just symbolic. They have the potential to halt production across multiple facilities, creating further challenges for the already embattled automaker. Stellantis' strategy shift. In the midst of these challenges, Stellantis is attempting to reposition itself for the future. One of its most notable moves has been the introduction of high-performance limited edition models like the Ram TRX Final Edition. This truck, with its supercharged 6.2-liter Hemi V8 engine producing 702 horsepower, is a beast on wheels. But with a price tag exceeding $249,000, it's a far cry from the affordable, practical trucks that built Ram's reputation. The decision to focus on high-end models has raised questions about Stellantis's long-term strategy. Are they trying to redefine Ram as a luxury brand, or are they simply cashing in on collectors and enthusiasts while phasing out traditional models? While these limited edition trucks generate buzz, they do little to address the concerns of everyday buyers who feel increasingly alienated by the brand's direction. Stellantis is also exploring opportunities in the mid-sized truck market, with rumors of a revived Ram Dakota and the recent debut of the Rampage in Brazil. These moves suggest an effort to diversify Ram's offerings and appeal to a broader customer base. However, entering the mid-size segment is no guarantee of success. Stellantis faces stiff competition from established players like Toyota, whose Tacoma has long been a favorite in this category. Consumer sentiment. For many loyal Ram customers, the current trajectory of the brand feels like a betrayal. Trucks that were once seen as dependable and accessible are now out of reach for many buyers. The focus on luxury and high-performance models may win over a niche audience, but it risks alienating the broader market that Ram has traditionally served. Dealerships are feeling the strain as well. Lots filled with unsold 2023 and 2024 models are becoming a common sight. Discounts, ranging from 12 to 20%, are being offered to entice buyers, but these markdowns come with their own risks. By consistently discounting their trucks, Stellantis may be training consumers to wait for deals, further eroding the brand's value. The future of Ram, and Stellantis as a whole, hinges on the company's ability to adapt to these challenges. Can they balance innovation with affordability? Will their push towards electrification resonate with buyers, or will it come at the cost of their loyal customer base? These questions remain unanswered, but one thing is clear: the road ahead will not be an easy one. Stellantis's gamble. As Stellantis grapples with its declining sales and the fading appeal of its once reliable Ram brand, the company has turned to a bold, albeit controversial, strategy: limited edition trucks. Leading the charge is the Ram TRX Final Edition, a truck designed to dazzle enthusiasts and collectors alike. With its eye-catching satin titanium bead lock wheels, distinct TRX badging, and a supercharged 6.2-liter Hemi V8 engine producing 702 horsepower, it's not just a truck, it's a statement. But at over $249,000 per unit, it's a statement that comes with a steep price tag. Stellantis has made only 4,000 units available globally, with a small fraction allocated to markets like the Middle East and Australia. For collectors, the scarcity of this model is part of its allure. For the average truck buyer, however, this price point is not just inaccessible, it's alienating. The gamble here is clear. Stellantis is banking on the exclusivity and performance of the TRX Final Edition to inject some much-needed excitement into the Ram lineup. Yet this approach raises an important question. Is Stellantis trying to innovate, or are they merely masking deeper problems with flashy one-offs? While these limited edition models generate short-term buzz, they do little to address the larger issues facing the company. The mid-sized revival. In an effort to expand its appeal, Stellantis has hinted at a potential return to the mid-size truck market. The Ram Dakota, once a strong contender in this category, could be making a comeback. Adding to the intrigue is the recent debut of the Ram Rampage in Brazil, a mid-size truck that has already started to generate buzz among industry watchers. This shift is not without merit. The mid-size truck market has been growing steadily, driven by demand for vehicles that offer the utility of a truck without the bulk of a full-sized model. Toyota's Tacoma and Ford's Ranger are prime examples of how successful this segment can be. By re-entering this market, Stellantis has the opportunity to tap into a broader customer base. However, the competition in this space is fierce, and Stellantis has a lot of ground to cover. Mid-sized trucks like the Tacoma have established themselves as reliable, versatile options with strong brand loyalty. To succeed, Stellantis will need to bring something truly innovative to the table, whether it's cutting-edge technology, superior performance, or a price point that undercuts its competitors. The changing market. Stellantis' commitment to electrification is both a necessity and a risk. The automotive industry is shifting rapidly toward electric vehicles, driven by stricter emissions regulations and changing consumer preferences. While brands like Tesla and Rivian have set the pace for EVs, traditional automakers are racing to catch up, and Stellantis is no exception. The transition to electric trucks is a central part of Stellantis' strategy. Models like the upcoming Ram Revolution EV promise to combine the power and utility of a traditional truck with the benefits of an electric drivetrain. These vehicles aim to appeal to environmentally conscious buyers while maintaining the rugged appeal that Ram is known for. But this shift is not without its challenges. Electric trucks come with higher production costs, and Stellantis will need to strike a balance between performance and affordability. Additionally, infrastructure for EVs, such as charging stations, remains a barrier for many consumers. Convincing loyal Ram customers to embrace electrification will require not only innovative vehicles, but also significant investments in consumer education and support. One of the most pressing challenges Stellantis faces is rebuilding trust with its customers. Ram has long been associated with rugged dependability and value, a brand that caters to hardworking individuals who need a truck they can rely on. The current trajectory, with its focus on high-end models and rising prices, risks eroding that trust. Many buyers are starting to question whether Ram still represents the values it once stood for. Trucks that were once within reach for middle-class consumers are now priced closer to luxury vehicles, creating a sense of exclusion. For longtime Ram enthusiasts, the introduction of limited edition models and the pivot toward electrification feel like a departure from the brand's core identity. This disconnect is further exacerbated by reliability issues and recalls, which have tarnished Ram's reputation. Customers who once swore by the brand are now looking elsewhere, drawn to competitors like Ford and Toyota that offer a more consistent ownership experience. The competitive landscape. The challenges facing Stellantis are made all the more daunting by the strength of its competitors. Ford, for example, continues to dominate the truck market with its F-Series lineup, which combines cutting-edge technology with a reputation for reliability. Chevy's Silverado has also been a strong performer, offering a compelling mix of affordability and performance. In the mid-size segment, Toyota's Tacoma is a standout. With a loyal customer base and a reputation for durability, even newer entrants like Hyundai's Santa Cruz and Ford's Maverick are making waves by offering innovative features at accessible price points. To regain its footing, Stellantis will need to differentiate itself in a crowded marketplace. This could mean doubling down on innovation, addressing reliability concerns, or finding ways to offer more competitive pricing. The stakes are high, and Stellantis cannot afford to lag behind in a market that is evolving faster than ever. Worker voices and union actions. While Stellantis focuses on repositioning its brand, workers on the factory floor are facing their own set of challenges. Layoffs and production cuts have left thousands of employees in precarious positions, fueling tensions within the workforce. The United Auto Workers Union has been vocal in its criticism of Stellantis, accusing the company of prioritizing profits over people. Union President Sean Fain has emerged as a key figure in this struggle, rallying workers with impassioned calls for action. Under his leadership, the UAW has organized strikes and filed grievances aimed at holding Stellantis accountable. The demands are clear: job security, fair wages, and a commitment to supporting workers during the transition to electrification. The outcome of these union actions could have far-reaching implications for Stellantis and the broader industry. A prolonged strike could disrupt production and further strain the company's finances, while a successful resolution could set a precedent for how automakers navigate the challenges of modernization. For Ram dealerships, the current situation is a double-edged sword. On one hand, the introduction of limited edition models like the TRX Final Edition creates buzz and draws attention to the brand. On the other hand, dealerships are struggling to move unsold inventory, with hundreds of 2023 and 2024 models sitting idle on lots. To address this issue, many dealers are offering deep discounts, ranging from 12 to 20% off the suggested retail price. While these discounts may help clear inventory in the short term, they come with their own risks. Consistently lowering prices can erode the perceived value of the brand, making it harder to justify premium pricing in the future. Additionally, the reliance on discounts underscores a deeper problem. Stellantis' pricing strategy is out of sync with market realities. Consumers are becoming increasingly price-sensitive, and many are turning to competitors that offer better value for their money. The road ahead. As Stellantis charts its path forward, it faces a series of difficult decisions. Can the company successfully pivot to electrification while maintaining the loyalty of its traditional customer base? Will the introduction of mid-sized trucks and limited edition models be enough to revive interest in the Ram brand? And most importantly, can Stellantis address the concerns of workers, dealers, and consumers in a way that ensures long-term success? The answers to these questions will define the future of not only the Ram brand, but also Stellantis as a whole. The road ahead is fraught with challenges, but it also offers opportunities for innovation and reinvention. For Stellantis, the stakes couldn't be higher. The future of the Ram brand is poised on a razor's edge, and Stellantis is attempting to redefine what it means to own a pickup truck in the modern era. The days of purely utilitarian vehicles are fading fast. Ram isn't just building trucks anymore. They're crafting aspirational vehicles that blend power, luxury, and cutting-edge technology. Whether this approach will resonate with consumers or alienate its core audience remains a pivotal question. Take the upcoming Ram Revolution EV, for example. This electric truck promises to deliver all the performance Ram customers have come to expect, but with a much greener footprint. Stellantis is positioning it as the next logical step for the brand, merging the ruggedness of Ram with the sustainability demands of a changing market. However, for longtime fans of gas-powered engines, this shift may feel like the loss of an identity that has defined Ram for decades. The challenge lies in striking the right balance. Stellantis needs to maintain Ram's legacy while evolving to meet the needs of a new generation of buyers. It's a tightrope walk that could determine whether Ram emerges as a leader in the truck market or fades into irrelevance. The legacy of Ram. The Ram 1500 may be facing its greatest challenge yet, but its legacy remains undeniable. For decades, this truck has been a symbol of strength, reliability, and practicality, carving out a loyal following among truck enthusiasts and everyday drivers alike. Whether hauling heavy loads on a job site or cruising down the highway on a road trip, Ram trucks have earned their place as a cornerstone of the American automotive landscape. However, legacy alone cannot sustain a brand in an industry that is evolving at an unprecedented pace. As Stellantis navigates the challenges of electrification, rising costs, and shifting consumer preferences, the future of the Ram brand hangs in the balance. The decisions made today will determine whether Ram continues to thrive as a leader in the truck market or becomes a relic of a bygone era. For Stellantis, the stakes couldn't be higher. The automotive industry is entering a new chapter, one defined by innovation, sustainability, and fierce competition. To succeed, Ram must embrace this transformation while staying true to the values that made it a household name. It's a delicate balancing act, but one that will define not only the future of the Ram brand, but also Stellantis' place in the automotive world. So what do you think lies ahead for Ram and Stellantis? Let us know your thoughts in the comment below and see you in the next video.